Hi everyone, my name is Ian Van Tile, and behind me is a new listing here in San Diego, California. It is a 2008 Hunter 45 deck salon, and this particular vessel is extremely loaded and fully turnkey. So let me show you some features and benefits about it.
All right, so here you can see this is Paradise. And one thing a Paradise offers is a really well-maintained vessel with lots of equipment. Here at the transom, you can see we have a really nice entryway that gradually leads you up into the cockpit. There is a swim ladder with two stainless steel handles, a swim step shower with hot and cold features. We have really nice stern rail seats here and amazing cushions throughout the vessel. There's also a stainless barbecue mounted off to the port side and custom stainless fender holders that are integrated into the Lifeline system. But here at the port helm, you can see we have the autopilot, we have our side power bow thruster, we have our Tri-Data VHF remote mic, electric Lumar winches, our engine instrument controls are just down below here. And what I really like is having the throttle control right here. So when you're operating the vessel, whether it be forward or reverse, you have a really nice control over the throttle and transmission. Centrally located is our Raymarine E120 GPS plotter. This is also integrated with the radar. This also pivots to both helm depending on where you're at, giving you great visible view of it. And it has an integrated stainless steel grab rail into the cockpit table. So off to the starboard side, we have a nice binnacle with a stainless steel grab rail here and also a Lumar electric winch. As we move our way up to the foredeck, I also want to point out just the attention to detail, the polished out welds into these solid rear lifelines. This is a very nice upgrade and addition. As we move up forward, you can see we have nice wide side decks, great stainless steel grab handles here mounted to the coach roof and also onto the Dodger. As we look up at the Selden infurling mast, we have custom UK sails. We also have double spreader mast with bird deterrent, flag halyard off to the starboard side and port, and radar reflector. One thing that the 45 deck salon possesses is this really unique wraparound window, really flooding the salon with a lot of natural light. The foredeck is quite unique with these custom lounge pads here with built-in head bolstering. And as we move up to the foredeck, we have our anchor locker with a Lumar electric windlass with two-speed up and down controls here and a second bow roller system for a second anchor and or a mooring line. Looking after the vessel now, you can see the BNR rig, double mast spreaders. We also have a LED deck light. It's just very well designed. Everything leading back into the cockpit, making this vessel very easy to single and shorthand sail. The vessel was just polished and buffed this week, and it really has an extreme shine to it, as you can see. And the owner just keeps this in a normal routine basis. One thing Hunter's known for is the stainless steel arch. There's a lot of benefits and you're seeing a lot of manufacturers go to the arch system. But one thing it does is it actually puts all the load on the very backside of the boom with very load-bearing weight on the main sheet and the traveler here, giving you great access to that and great control over your main. In the stainless steel arch, we have integrated speakers with a light here that illuminates the cockpit. Beautiful Corian cockpit table here, again, with fold-up table leaves that open up. Nice storage area here. Two very large stowage lockers on both starboard and port side. The other thing that the arch possesses on this particular model is a double-ended main sheet. So the main sheet comes to this clutch here, leads down to the block to this winch. So you can control both head sail and mainsail without leaving the cockpit. So really great control with that. Everything's also led into the cockpit cabin top as well, where there is a electric starboard winch. Just forward of that, you can see the additional depth, speed, our stereo controllers. And again, off to the port side, we have furl in, furl out, jib halyard, spinnaker halyard. Now let's go down below the vessel. And the nice thing I want to point out is the gradual steps coming down below the vessel. But here you go. This is really what the Deck Salon possesses. Just a really amazing amount of openness, a great feel. And there's about 7 foot two, I'll take an exact measurement, 7 foot four headroom in here. So if you're a tall guy and you're looking for a lot of space, this is the perfect model. A phenomenal chef's galley here. Lots of storage or subsole stowage. We have a pantry area here, a built-in LG microwave. Again, freezer, 3-burner stove and oven, dedicated trash can, 2 stainless steel sinks, and a full refrigerator here. But again, it's so nice and open. You really feel like you're part of, you know, any group if you're in the galley, and it just has a nice feel to it. Directly across from the galley is our day head and shower, which I'll get to in a little bit. Forward of this is our nav station. Now, the nav station is quite nice because it is open. You had a great forward-facing seating. Down below the nav stations are battery switches, our switches to our underwater lights, a bilge counter, macerator, tank indicator, Xantrax inverter charger, and the Fisher Panda generator control panel. Just above that is the ship's electrical breaker. So this is really easy to access, quick on off. And then there is a full breaker system behind the seating here on the starboard side. So in the salon itself, we have a nice large salon table. This drops down and can turn into a bed if so desired. This is the upgraded leather. So you can see it is in amazing condition with great French stitching. We have our thermostat controls for our air conditioning and heating system. And down below here is our water maker controller. But again, look at these windows. Look how nice it is to just stand here and just look out. Overhead opening hatches. And again, just a really nice open feel throughout. We have a Bose 3-2-1 system with subwoofer. This is a CD, DVD player, stereo system. And then there is a built-in flat screen television. As we move our way up to the forward cabin, this is a Pullman berth. So it's a nice double Pullman berth for two people. Behind the door here is a nice cedar-lined hanging locker closet. We have a nice vanity with Corian countertops, sink, and lots of stowage found throughout the bed and underneath the sink area. We move up to the head and shower compartment. We have Japsco Quiet Flush toilet, a nice head compartment here. This teak seat folds down, so it creates a bench seat here. But again, look how they trimmed out all of the accessories, all of the flat surfaces. They really did a great job. And this gives you a better look at that twin berth. So you can easily fit two people here. And again, lots of stowage found throughout. As we make our way back aft through the vessel, a couple things I want to point out. Just again, the attention to detail and the woodwork, the door construction, they really do a phenomenal job. We have our batteries located directly below here and great access to the bilge just aft of that. Great engine access. So you have this small door here that just lifts up for quick access to the engine. Otherwise, there are 4 straps that take off the main steps, and that slides out of the way. You're going to see that from some of my pictures, and access to the rear of the motor as well. But this is the second head and shower. So again, this is quite nice. You have a separate shower stall here with a built-in bench seat, close-off door, so that's completely isolated. And what I really like is you have access into the master cabin from this head as well too. So you can use it as a day head, but you can use it as a private head for the master cabin. Now, talking about master cabins, this is truly exceptional. This is a centerline queen berth here, and this allows you to have access on and off the bed from both starboard and port sides. Directly across from us is a massive hanging locker closet. We have built-in storage bins here. There are opening hatches. There's 2 on both starboard and port. We have 110 outlets by each bed. Lots of lighting, air conditioning vents that you see there. And directly off to the starboard side, you can see additional shelving and hanging locker space. The floors themselves are Everwear floors, so this simulates a teak and holly, but this flooring is actually very, very durable, and it is really well appreciated and gives a nice rich look throughout the vessel.
Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. I know it was quick. There's a lot of systems on this boat, and this is something that I would definitely take a look at. So please feel free to call me at any time, day or night, and I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again for watching.